Hello everybody. Today I am going to tell you the properties of eigenvalue. In my previous video I have told you how to find out eigenvalues, eigenvectors, eigenspaces and everything. Okay, so see, if lambda is an eigenvalue of the matrix A, then lambda to the n is an eigenvalue of A to the n. That means lambda square will be the eigenvalue of A square, lambda to the 3 will be the eigenvalue of A to the 3 and so on. So see here, by the definition, if lambda is an eigenvalue of A, then Ax is equal to lambda x for some non-zero vector x, and that x is called the eigenvector. Clear? Now therefore, A square x can be written as A into X. So this is A into AX because associative. Matrix multiplication is associative. And AX is equal to lambda X. So A into lambda X. So lambda is a constant. It can go to the outside. So remain AX. So lambda into AX is lambda X. So it is lambda square X. See here. A into X is a lambda into X. That means lambda is an eigenvalue of AX. A. So A square X is a lambda square X. That means lambda square is an eigenvalue of A square. Similarly, A to the 3 into X is equal to A square into AX. So A square into, again it will be better, A into A square. So A into A square X. So it will be, put a bracket here. Then A into A square X, I have already proved lambda square X. So lambda square X. And it will be lambda square into AX. Is equal to lambda square into lambda X. Is equal to lambda cube X. So A cube X is equal to lambda cube X. That means lambda cube is an eigenvalue of A cube. Therefore, similarly, proceeding inductively, we will get A to the N into X is equal to A into A to the N minus 1 into X. Is equal to A into A to the N minus 1 into X, which is equal to A into lambda to the N minus 1 into X, which is equal to lambda to the N minus 1 into AX, is equal to lambda to the N minus 1 into lambda X, which is equal to lambda to the A into X. That means lambda to the N is an eigenvalue of A to the N. You should write, therefore lambda to the N is an eigenvalue of A to the N. This is your first property. Clear? I am giving some examples. See here. If 2, 3 are the eigenvalues, these are the subtypes. Eigenvalues of A, then the eigenvalues A square are, but what will be the eigenvalue of A square? Simply square of these two. 4 and 9. So this is the answer. Clear? Come to the second property. If lambda is an eigenvalue of A, then lambda is also an eigenvalue of A transpose. So now, AX is lambda X. Or, you may take, that is, determinant of A minus lambda I equal to 0. I can write like this. So it implies, and we know determinant of A is equal to determinant of A transpose. So we can write determinant of A minus lambda I transpose equal to 0. So determinant of, apply the property of transpose, A transpose minus lambda into I transpose equal to 0. That means determinant of A transpose minus lambda into I, because the transpose of unit matrix is itself. So compare these two. If lambda is an eigenvalue of the matrix A, then A minus, determinant of A minus lambda I equal to 0. So compare these two. In place of A, I have written A transpose, and in place of lambda, same as lambda. That means if lambda is an eigenvalue of A, then lambda is also an eigenvalue of A transpose. Clear? Therefore, lambda is an eigenvalue of A transpose. See here, example I am giving you. If 2, 4, 5 at the eigenvalue of A, then the eigenvalue of A transpose are gas. That means 10, 2, 4, 5 will be the eigenvalue of A transpose.
Clear?
See here, given lambda is an eigenvalue of A. That means Ax is equal to lambda x for some x, for some non-zero x. Clear? Now we have to prove k lambda is an eigenvalue of ka. So simply multiply k to both the sides, k into lambda x. So I can write k a into x is equal to k lambda into x. So compare this one with this one. In place of lambda I have written k lambda, in place of a I have written k a. That means k lambda is an eigenvalue of k a.
Clear?
So I am giving an example. If 5, 7 are the eigenvalues of A, then the eigenvalues of 2A is equal to gas.
What is the eigenvalue of 2A?
Simply multiply 2. It will be 10 and 14. Clear? So 10 and 14 are the eigenvalues of 2A. See here, very important property. This is fourth property. If lambda is an eigenvalue of the matrix A, then G of lambda is an eigenvalue of G of A, where G of X is a polynomial. Clear? So let G of A is equal to A0 plus A1 into A plus A2 into A square plus so on An into A to the power N. So this is G of A. So what will be G of lambda? G of lambda is equal to A0 plus A1 lambda plus A2 lambda square plus An lambda to the power N. Now, we have to prove G of lambda is an eigenvalue of G of A. That means G of A into X is equal to G of lambda into X. We want to prove this one. If we prove this one, G of A into X is equal to G of lambda into X, so G of lambda will be the eigenvalue of G of A. Clear? So now, proceed from the left hand side. G of A into X is equal to, what is G of A? This one. A0 plus A1A plus A2A square plus An A to the power N into X. So multiply A0X plus A1 into AX, A2 into A square X. I am directly writing An into A to the power N into X. So A0X plus AX is equal to lambda X. Clear? Plus A2 into this is lambda square x, An this is lambda to the n x. So take x common again. A0 plus A1 lambda plus A2 lambda square plus An lambda to the n all into x. And this is your g of lambda into x. Therefore g of lambda is an eigenvalue of g of A. Clear? See here, your fifth property. If lambda is an eigenvalue of A, then 1 by lambda is an eigenvalue of A inverse, provided A should be a non-singular matrix. Non-singular matrix means determinant of A is unequal to 0. So if lambda is an eigenvalue of A, then Ax is lambda A for some non-zero vector x. Now, given determinant of A is unequal to 0, it implies A inverse exists. Clear? Now, Ax is equal to lambda x. So multiply both sides with A inverse. and pre multiplying. That means apply associative law. A inverse A into x equal to lambda into A inverse x. I am taking lambda outside. So this is I. So I into x is equal to lambda into A inverse x. Then what is the value of A inverse? A inverse x. So A inverse x is equal to take lambda to that side will be 1 by lambda into ix. That means 1 by lambda into x. I into x is x. So from these two, it is clear that 1 by lambda is an eigenvalue of A inverse. Clear? And give you an example, very important example. If 2, 3 are the eigenvalues of the non-singular matrix A, then the eigenvalues A inverse are, I have told you, if lambda is an eigenvalue of A, then 1 by lambda is an eigenvalue of A inverse. That will be the reciprocal of lambda. So, ratio of this one is 1 by 2, ratio of this one is 1 by 3. So, 1 by 2 and 1 by 3. Clear? See, your sixth property, lambda is equal to 0 is an eigenvalue of the matrix A, if only A is singular. That means if a matrix is singular, then the eigenvalue is simply lambda is equal to 0. Clear? Let us prove that. This one. We know if lambda is an eigenvalue of the matrix A, then determinant of A minus lambda I equal to 0. So let lambda is equal to 0 is an eigenvalue of A. So implies and implied by determinant of A minus 0 I equal to 0. Implies and implied by determinant of A equal to 0. And the matrix whose determinant is 0, it is a singular matrix. A is singular. Clear? So if the matrix is singular, then the eigenvalue is lambda is equal to 0. You can write directly. Clear? See here, the eigenvalue of a diagonal matrix are its diagonal elements. Let us take an example. Let A is equal to A 0 0, 0 B 0, 0 0 C. Or I am taking A 1 1, A 2 2, A 3 3. Like this I am taking. So for eigenvalue lambda, we have determinant of A minus lambda I equal to 0. That means A 1 1 minus lambda 0 0 0, A 2 2 minus lambda 0 0 0, A 3 3 minus lambda, determinant equal to 0. And I have told you, what is the value of the determinant of a diagonal matrix? The product of the diagonal elements. Clear? So simply A 1 1 minus lambda, A 2 2 minus lambda, A 3 3 minus lambda equal to 0. That means lambda is equal to A 1 1, A 2 2, A 3 3. So these are the eigenvalues which are the diagonal elements of a diagonal matrix. Clear? The eigenvalues of a triangular matrix are the diagonal elements. Let us take the upper triangular matrix. So it is A 1 1, A 1 2, A 1 3, 0, A 2 2, A 2 3, 0 0, A 3 3. This is an upper triangular matrix. So for eigenvalue lambda A minus lambda I, determinant is equal to 0. That means determinant of A 1 1 minus lambda, A 1 2, A 1 3, 0 0, this is A 2 2 minus lambda, this is A 2 3 and 0, A 3 3 minus lambda, determinant equal to 0. So already I have told you, what is the value of the determinant of a triangular matrix? Simply the product of the diagonal elements. So that means this will be this to this. So A 1 1 minus lambda, A 2 2 minus lambda, A 3 3 minus lambda equal to 0. That means lambda is equal to a11, a22, a33, which are the diagonal elements. Clear? So it may be upper triangular matrix, it may be lower triangular matrix. Simply the eigenvalues of a triangular matrix are the diagonal elements. See here. We have given lambda is an eigenvalue of the matrix A. Given Ax is equal to lambda x. For some non-zero vector x. Now since determinant A is not equal to 0, that means it is non-singular, so it implies A inverse exists. And already we know from previous property, 1 by A inverse x to 1 by lambda into x. That means if lambda is an eigenvalue of the matrix A, which is non-singular matrix, then 1 by lambda is an eigenvalue of A inverse. So simply, and already you, another property was there, if lambda is an eigenvalue of the matrix A, then K lambda is an eigenvalue of K A. That means if we multiply any constant, nothing will change. So simply, multiply determinant of A to both the sides. Determinant of A into A inverse X is equal to determinant of A by lambda into X. That means determinant of A by lambda is an eigenvalue of A inverse. Determinant of A into A inverse, but we know A inverse is equal to adjoint of A by determinant of A. So A inverse into determinant, A inverse into determinant is equal to adjoint of A. So here we can write adjoint of A. Adjoint of A into X, your determinant of A by lambda into X. So that means determinant of A by lambda is on eigenvalue of adjoint of A. Clear? See here, these are some of the properties. Only you have to remember, and I will apply these properties to the MCQ questions directly. See here. And these two properties are very, very important properties. Actually, in multiple choice questions, for any entrance examinations, you should apply only these two properties. Sum of the eigenvalues of a matrix is equal to trace of A, and trace means sum of the diagonal elements. Trace of A means sum of the diagonal elements. Clear? Then the product of the, this symbol is for product. Don't read as pi. Product of the eigenvalues of the matrix A is equal to determinant of A. Clear? And you want to remember these properties. Eigenvalues of an orthogonal matrix of absolute values 1. Because the eigenvalues of an orthogonal matrix, either it may be real or complex. It will be. But the modulus will be 1. Here, the eigenvalues of a unitary matrix, either it will be real or complex. But the modulus will be 1. And the eigenvalues of a skew Hermitian matrix are purely imaginary or 0. If there will be 4 options. But in one of the options, it is purely imaginary or 0, then that option is the correct answer. See here, if lambda is an eigenvalue of A, then lambda is also an eigenvalue of transpose of A bar, transpose conjugate of A. Again, the eigenvalue of a symmetric matrix are purely real, and the eigenvalue of a Hermitian matrix are purely also real. So these are the properties, these are the total number of properties I have given, 17. So please remember all these properties for the next class. That means tomorrow. So that I will give you or I will solve some very, very important questions from GATE examination, from PG entrance examination, from IIT JAM questions also. I will do the problems. Okay?